Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. This is our seventh video that I will teach you daily phrases in Turkish. That means günlük kalıplar. Before, I already taught you the Islamic phrases. This is not Islamic ones, this is normal phrases that we use in Turkish. So the first one is saying thanks. You can say teşekkür ederim or teşekkürler or sağ ol. So, if it's a formal conversation, you can say sağ olun. Or you can add çok. Çok means so much. So, teşekkür ederim means thank you. Çok teşekkür ederim means thank you so much. Çok teşekkürler. Çok sağ ol. Çok sağ olun. In this one, actually, teşekkürler is like thanks. Teşekkür ederim is thank you. You can think like that. When someone say thank you to you, you are saying you're welcome. That means rica ederim or ne demek or önemli değil or bir şey değil. Önemli değil means it's not important. Bir şey değil means it's nothing. Rica ederim, you are welcome. You can use any of these things. Any of them is okay. So when someone tell you thank you, they say eyvallah. Eyvallah, thank you. Or when someone say thank you to you, you say eyvallah. That means you're welcome. You can use for both. Eyvallah is so useful in Turkish. If you want to say I'm sorry, we say özür dilerim. Or you can say kusura bakma. For the answer, you can say canın sağ olsun. Canın sağ olsun means it's okay. Whatever you did, it's okay. Just you remain alive. Canın sağ olsun. Or you can say sorun değil. Sorun değil means no problem. You can say problem değil also. Problem. Problem is problem in Turkish. We say, we write the same way, but we read like problem. Problem değil. Or sorun değil. Or önemli değil. Önemli değil means not important. When you want to say congrats to someone, I said this one in the other video also, hayırlı olsun. Or you can say gözün aydın. Or gözünüz aydın in the formal conversation. Or you can just say gözün aydın. I'm happy for you. That means senin adına sevindim. Senin adına sevindim. So congrats. This one is also, it's like hayırlı olsun, but it's a bit different because it is, we say, after an achievement. For example, you can join a university, college, or you just win some contest. So we say tebrikler. This one is kolay gelsin. Kolay gelsin means may it be easy for you. For example, when we are walking on the street, we see someone we know doing something hard work in the side of the road. Like, for example, he is planting something like that. So we say, kolay gelsin. It is like saying, hey. But we say, may it be easy for you. Kolay gelsin. Or when you get inside a shop, you want to buy something, right? So when you get inside a shop, we say, kolay gelsin. I want to buy this and that. That's also like greeting also you can use. For example, a person who is close to you doing something and you call that person kolay gelsin. So that person may tell you kolaysa başına gelsin. That's the funny way to say kolaysa başına gelsin. If it is easy, you do that. Just say kolay gelsin. When we see someone is working, we say hayırlı işler. That means I wish you good work. Hayırlı işler. I wish you success. Başarılar. You can say this to a student or someone like that. Başarılar. When you see someone who is eating food, you can say afiyet olsun. That means bon appetit. And as a response, other person may tell you, come and join us. If you are a friend, for example, come and join us. That means gel beraber olsun. Other one is eline sağlık. Or you can say ellerine sağlık. Both are same. When I translate, that means may your hands be healthy. But we use that for saying thanks for the food. Like, you know, someone cook something, thanks for the food that you cook. For example, you say eline sağlık to the person. Other person will tell you again, afiyet olsun. The response of eline sağlık is afiyet olsun. So we say that to the kids. You are so happy to see him eating food well. So you are saying yarasın. That means may it give you health. Or löp löp et olsun. That means may it make you gain weight. It's a funny way to say. Yarasın, löp löp et olsun. We say that to the kids most of the time. Kesene bereket. May you have baraka in your pocket. You bought something. The guy who sell the stuff saying kesene bereket. Someone just treat you a dinner because that person paid the money behalf of you. So you say kesene bereket. It's like thank you. Other one is ayağına sağlık or ayaklarına sağlık. Both are okay. That means may your feet be healthy when I translate. Or but we say this thing for saying thanks for visiting me. Ayağına sağlık. Get well soon. Geçmiş olsun. When a person just take shower or just get a haircut or shave, we say sıhhatler olsun. Sıhhatler olsun. So, my condolences means başın sağ olsun. Or if it's a formal person for us, başınız sağ olsun. And other person will respond to you, dostlar sağ olsun. When someone sneezes, we say çok yaşa. Or you can say hayırlı yaşa. It's Islamic version to say. Çok yaşa means live long. Hayırlı yaşa means live with hayır in your life. So other person will respond to you saying sen de gör. Or he can say hep beraber. Hep beraber means all together. Sen de gör means for you too. When someone cough, we just hit that person's back actually. Then we say helal. Sometimes we say that twice, like helal, helal. The logic behind that thing is, for example, when you give a food to someone, you should make that helal, right? If it's haram for that person, it will stuck in his throat. So we say helal, helal. I made that food helal for you. But it just become a habit. Whenever someone coughs, even if it's not because of a food or something, we say helal. May Allah protect from evil eye. It's kind of Islamic way, but it's also a cultural thing. So we say, Mashallah, Subhanallah. You can say, Mashallah, Subhanallah. This is Islamic version. Or you can say, Nazar değmesin. Nazar is evil eye. Nazar değmesin means, may Allah protect you from evil eye. Or may Allah protect it from evil eye. For example, someone bought a car. You can say, Nazar değmesin, even for the car. Allah göstermesin. When you talk about, for example, earthquake. You say Allah göstermesin. Evlerden ırak. That means may Allah protect us from that. You can say this differently or together. Doesn't matter. Evlerden ırak means may it be far from our home. So güle güle means bye bye. I teach you before in the previous lesson. But you can say the same thing using the same phrase. For example, someone bought a new car. You say güle güle kullan. Use that as smiling. Someone bought a new dress. Güle güle giy. Wear that as smiling. Güle güle otur. Live in that house as smiling. Güle güle git. Go as smiling. You can use all the versions. Güle güle kullan. Güle güle git. You can use that güle güle for anything. It means as smiling, while smiling. So when you're with your friends and you're saying, ah, I gotta go now. I have to go now. So you're saying, bana müsaade. Or ben kaçar. Bana müsaade is better to say. Ben kaçar is nowadays slang only. Or, for example, you went to a place as a guest to your neighbor's home. You are saying, bana müsaade. Let me go now. Other person will say, oturuyorduk ne güzel. Ah, we were sitting so good. Why you wanna go now? Oturuyorduk ne güzel. Or other person can say again, daha karpuz kesecektik. Are we gonna cut watermelon for you now? It doesn't mean that that person gonna cut watermelon for you. It's just a saying. Even one of your friends tell you that he wanna go. You can say, oturuyorduk ne güzel. Why you wanna go now? Just sit with us more. We have a guest. And they are going from our home. So when we are saying goodbye to them, we say, gene gelin. Or, yine gelin. Or, yine bekleriz. Or, çıkın çıkın gelin. This çıkın çıkın gelin is a bit local way to say, but it is fun to use. You can say that too. Gene gelin means come again. Yine gelin. Yine bekleriz. We wait for you again. Çıkın çıkın gelin. It is for the neighbor you can say. Just go out of your home and come to us. Çıkın çıkın gelin. So other person will say come visit us too. Bize de bekleriz. Bize de buyurun. This is when we are going somewhere again. When we are with some people we say hadi bana müsaade. Let me go. Hadi görüşürüz. Then see you. Hadi eyvallah. It all means like you can use this hadi all of them. Hadi bana müsaade. Hadi görüşürüz. Hadi eyvallah. It all means that let me go. See you later. Hadi gene iyisin. You are in luck. You are so lucky. Well done. Aferin. Happy birthday means iyi ki doğdun. Or you can say doğum günün kutlu olsun. Happy New Year means mutlu yıllar. Happy New Year. So thanks for watching my video. Our 7th video is over. Inshallah in my next video I will teach you how to read the numbers. So it will be so useful. Wait for my next video. Like my videos, share my videos and subscribe to my channel and follow me on social media. Assalamu alaikum.